Okay, so let's look back at the tmdb client.swift file. There are two commented methods in this file called taskForget method and taskForPost method. The goals of these methods is to take the duplicate code that exists for the get request and the post request that we're making to the movie database and moving them here. Now you could create different methods for this goal. They don't have to be called taskForget method and taskForPost method. Those were just some names that we chose for this example. Now you could even split these methods, taskForget method and taskForPost method, into smaller methods, each specialized for a different part of making a network task. So maybe building the URL, making the task, and then you could have something that checks the errors. And I'd highly encourage that. But for now, we're just going to work with these two methods. So I'm going to delete these real quick. And use them as a way of giving you an idea of how this kind of process works, how this process of better architecting our apps works. Because at the end of the day, what we're really trying to accomplish here is better design of our code. And if you talk to 10 different developers, you might get 10 different ideas about what better design is. But that's kind of another topic. For now, let's just focus on what these methods take as parameters and what they return so that we can work on this specific example. Each method takes a string parameter called method. The intent of this parameter is to represent the API method that should be used by the request. So remember, these are things like authentication, validate with token, or slash account. These were the methods that we're talking about. Then our second parameter, for lack of a better word, is called parameters, and it's a variable parameter. And it takes any of the parameters that we want to specify in the URL, such as the API key. These are things that go in the query portion of the URL. Next, for the taskForPost method, we have this extra parameter that's not included in taskForget called JSON body. And of course, this parameter allows us to pass in values into the HTTP body of a post request. And we'll look at it more later. Now, the last parameter is where these two methods get really interesting. Both methods end with a closure parameter called a completion handler forget in this case, and completion handler for post in the taskForPost method. Now remember, a closure is just a block of code. If you need a refresher on closures, I recommend that you go back and watch the Swift syntax section that we have on closures. Now these closures that we've called completion handlers, they're very similar to the completion handlers that you've seen before when we've used the NSURL sessions data task for request. And we can look at an example of that over here. Remember those completion handlers, they had the data response and error parameters, and these completion handlers aren't run until the data task itself completes, and then it executes this block of code. These things are very similar here on the left, these completion handlers, very similar, but the signature is just a little bit different. These completion handlers take result, which could be any object, and an optional NS error, and they return void or nothing. We're going to use these completion handlers to pass back the resulting data from our network request in the result parameter, or if an error happens for our request, then we'll pass back the error in the error parameter. If that was hard to follow, then let's pause and let's take a look at the taskForGetImage method. It's already implemented and it has a similar completion handler. It's called completion handler for image, and it's going to look very much like what we'll do for these two methods. So let's take a look at this one real quick. So in this method, we start by building the URL, and the URL is so we can make a network request for some image. Keep scrolling. Here we go. It makes the request, and in the completion handler for the request, it starts with our series of guard statements to make sure that there was no error. And then assuming all these guard statements pass, then it calls the completion handler for image. And it passes the resulting data, the image data, and because there was no error, it passes nil for the error. And then it calls the resume method for the task to make sure it runs, and then we return the network task. Now the network task being returned here is just an implementation detail. Don't worry about that for now. Let's focus on this call to the completion handler for image. This line of code, it calls the closure that's passed into taskForGetImage. It's calling this closure. So let's see what this looks like if we're to call taskForGetImage. That's going to make this make a lot more sense, I think. Now back in our login view controller, let's pretend that I want to call taskForGetImage. So to call this, I'm going to specify some phony size and file path, and then we'll get to the completion handler for image closure part. Now, this is where we get a real opportunity to see the power of closures. Here, where I'm calling task forget image, I want to specify what I want to happen when this task completes. Now, this closure, which we've specified as a trailing closure, it has access to the image data and any error that may have occurred. And we can get rid of void here. If you think about it, this is the exact same behavior that we want with our task forget method and task for post method. Inside of our view controller, so this is our login view controller, remember, we want to be able to make our request using the client, so the TMDB client's being used, and then when the request completes, we can use the resulting data or the error right in the view controller. And this helps reduce the complexity of our view controllers because it puts all the networking code into the client. We don't see any networking code here. We just see the task that we're wanting to call, and we see, hey, we're going to get some data back or some error back. What do you want to do with it? So from the perspective of the view controller, we don't really care how the networking works. We just want to know, are there results or was there an error? And then we can handle those cases appropriately. Okay, so that was a lot to take in. So let's just pause for a second. If you need to take a deep breath, if you need to go back and rewatch this video from the beginning, feel free. When you're ready to move forward, we're going to get started with task forget method. It's going to look a lot like this task forget image in the sense that it's going to allow our view controllers to just make the call and then have our completion handler, our closure here, specify what we want to do with the results.